Hey Cancer, welcome to your December 28th to January 3rd reading. I'm excited to see how you bring in the new year. So just the boring things first. Of course, if you like this video, please give me a like and subscribe to my channel. Also, if you are interested, I am offering a 2021 full year forecast on Vimeo. So all you have to do is I have the link in the description for this video. So if you're interested in renting or purchasing it, it's only a few dollars and you can get your full 2021 forecast. So yeah, and I will be doing more videos, like extra videos like that. So stay tuned. All right, no flyer cards, and that feels good. I'm curious to see what is up for the week ahead. All right. Let's see here. You know, every single video I have recorded for this week, so the readings I've done so far, there are a lot of similarities. There's definitely a sense of everybody just wanting to do away with the past and move forward. So, and you are no different, Cancer. We have the Justice card crossed with the Ten of Swords. So you see the Ten of Swords. I mean, I'm sure we've talked about this in your videos before, but there's a person, a man, and he's got 10 swords in his back. He's probably dead. Let's be real. Not having a good day. But the 10 marks the end of a cycle. So, and it's like things can't get any fucking worse. Hooray! So that's the good news. And with it crossing the Justice card, this is a very clear message saying that, hey, you are at the end of a cycle. You are bringing the new year in with new energy and things are starting to go your way. So that Justice card has to do with, and like if there is, I mean, I do not comment on serious legal issues or stuff like that because I'm not a lawyer. However, if you are going through some legal stuff, or if you are going through something where you feel completely wronged, this is a card that is saying that things are going to go your way and like it's a justice will be served, essentially. So and down here we have the Temperance card. So just at the base of this reading, the one message for you, Cancer, is that you need to be patient. Nothing's going to happen super quick for you, not right now, but things are going to be going your way. So you just need to be patient. The Nine of Cups, which is the luckiest card in the deck, is also coming up around this. So luck is on your side. You are protected. You are blessed. And you are going to be going through a period of good luck. So I do feel like the last little chunk of time has taken a toll on you though, Cancer. So I feel like with this Five of Cups coming up, I just feel like it's kind of like you've been kicked down so many times that you're tired. And you're like, yeah, like I'm really looking forward to something new and starting this year fresh, but you're tired and you're not feeling the best. And that's okay. That will start to change. The Hanged Man's also coming up. So, and it's really interesting. He's coming up reversed and just that he's not that I really pay attention to the different positions of the spread, but it's coming up in your hopes and fears position. And to me, that's kind of saying like, I feel like you're really starting to think about not only your boundaries, but like why you do certain things. Like, have you been living a very materialistic life, and then 2020 kind of scared you or set you straight? Do you live your life to impress other people? Like, what is your why? Why do you do what you do? And I feel like you're kind of going through some kind of awakening where you're really like, why do I do the things I do? Why do I hang out with the people I hang out with? And why do I value people's opinion so much? So that is a very eye-opening place to be. And that in itself can take a toll on you, but it's also so beautiful because you're really figuring yourself out. So good on you, Cancer. I do feel like things have just, it's like, and I mean, I get this, of course, like, it's like you've been having to work 2-3 times as hard to get the results you normally got, like maybe a year ago. And I get it. And you're fucking tired. But I will say, things are going to change. Things are already changing, and things will be going your way and getting better. So I definitely feel that. We also have the King of Wands. There's a lot of wands here, actually. So there is opportunity coming your way. I feel like you might have, there might be somebody you know, either a friend or a family member or a mentor or something, that you thought they might have your back a little more, but you're slowly finding out that this person is more like, they'll help you if it's easy, but if they have to put in a lot of effort, they're kind of like, nah, I got other stuff to do. So you're also learning that you really have to start relying on yourself. And again, it's about those boundaries. Who do you let into your life and who do you trust, right? So this is deep. Okay, that was like a whole chunk of cards. That was like 15 cards right there. I'm not going to pull those ones out even though they kind of fell out. But let's see. Let's pull a few more cards for you and see what else I can add to this. Yes, yes, yes. So there is the Page of Pentacles, which is news of money, and like money, inheritance, business propositions, a raise, a new job. There is some kind of news like that coming to you. And not only that, but it's just reinforcing, this Five of Swords is reinforcing that you've been to battle and you are at the point where you can now look at it in the rearview mirror instead of having to look at it every day. It's like, it's done, it's over. You're moving on to better things. And with the Queen of Cups coming up, I just feel like whatever this opportunity is, it's coming from a place of love. So maybe you know this person, or I don't know, or honestly, like if you want to get a little woo-woo, I almost feel like your spirit guides are like, okay, you know what? Here you go. You're ready. Like here, present for you. So if you believe in spirit guides, I do. So but other than that, like things are really going to move forward. And with the Four of Wands coming up, this is also a card of celebration. So even though things have been so hard and you're ready to give up, this next week is going to be awesome for you. And I feel like you're really going to be bringing in the new year with new energy. So Cancer, I hope you enjoyed this reading, and if you did, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Again, if you want that year ahead forecast, link is in the description of this video. So almost called you Gemini. Cancer, I will see you next year. So that's bye-bye for now.